can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Denver Broncos and the Miami Dolphins. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Tua wants to throw it on second down. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. Time and space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31.
We expected this defense to be tested by this passing game coming into this one. And there's an example on this first possession of the game.
They'll run for the first time here with Matt Breida. And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. And throw right side complete to Parker. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find wide receiver position. And that was special there.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards. So just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan.
Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football, but at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
At the 25-yard line.
From the gun, it's Locke.
He finds an opening past the 40.
Got an open man here, and it's K.J. Hamler. And he'll finally be taken down just shy of midfield. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Now the first carry here for Philip Lindsay. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. From midfield, here's Locke. To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 11 yards there, first down. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off, because it took it away, right? So now you got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out. Game, and that may carry over for you.
Second and 6.
From the 36, Locke. This is the tight end Fan. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 21. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. First down, Richmond. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
On second down, Richmond. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for us.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos have taken the early lead.
The losing streak had taken on a life of its own, and I think it infiltrates a team when you're on that much of a slide. But this group has managed to focus, come out early, and put a touchdown on the board. They look like they mean business in this one.
They do. Now the key, holding on to that attitude, because, man, that streak has been a struggle for them. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there. Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
They'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for third down. From the gun, it's Tua. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
That certainly looks like nothing to show now from these first 2 possessions. And guess what? When you're on a losing streak, that can lead to a full sense of here we go again. So on the sidelines, the offensive play callers, quarterback, they've got to get together and dial something up to start their next drive. Otherwise, it could be a long game.
They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Hamler now on the return. Just a net of 34 there following a punt of 44 yards. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up two touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. It was Raekwon Davis with the tackle. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. A run with Lindsey out of the gun. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Broncos 7, Dolphins nothing.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Locke working out of the gun. He's got a man. It's Sutton. That's complete. And he will have a Broncos first down, although it doesn't appear to be by much. He needed 4, and he got 4 on third down. Down Richmond, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
And the Broncos first down.
Now Locke on the bootleg. This is Hamler on the receiving end. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
First down. Well, one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And able to steer clear of that first tackler as he works his way forward for about 4. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. And he'll give it here to his running back. And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
From the gun on third down, Locke. Got a man complete. It's Hamler. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. KJ Hamler, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0.
Next the score, Broncos 14, Dolphins nothing.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
At their own 25-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. 2 drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. So that's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
2nd and 6.
On 2nd down, a run with Breida. Oh, he breaks a tackle, and he's got an alley. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Matt Breida, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins strike quickly here for 6 points.
The CD, I mean, there are touchdown runs, and then there are touchdown runs, and that one certainly fell into the latter category, and that deserves a couple exclamation points.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it.
And got his man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 33 yards that time. Well, one thing's for sure. They're going to have to come up with something at halftime because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do, put a man on him. The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing. Change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Shotgun snap to Locke. Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
And the Broncos first down.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. Second and 7. Lock. And the pass is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Jerry Judy. Jerry Judy with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Broncos push further out in front. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
At the 24-yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Tua sets up to pass it. And he is going to be taken down. They got him. As that is going to take us to the 2-minute warning. Bradley Chubb in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning. A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. Third and long, it's Tagovailoa. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And he
takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point from McManus is good, and that pushes the lead up to an even 20. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Dolphins take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Tagovailoa trying again after the pick six. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
He's going to wind up and air it out. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off at the 22. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. Now, sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
The pass there complete to Sutton. A gain of six there on first.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Throwing again on second down. Locke, he'll find Lindsey here. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
He dumps it underneath here to Lindsey. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's going to get it down to the 14-yard line. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. With a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter three is underway. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. One play has them up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Locke. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Giving back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down.
play action. Lock.
He'll get that complete to Albert O.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
The 43-yard line.
That pass play wound up for negative yardage. So here's second and 11. Locke looks to throw it again. He completes this to Sutton. And a loose football. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 21. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, and the pass is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Jerry Jeudy.
Touchdown.
Jerry Jeudy. His second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Broncos add on.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. McManus's point after is good, and that will extend this big lead.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Take over first and 10.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train? Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. So that time, Charles, a quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly. On second down, Tua. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Parker unable to get that one, and that takes us from second to third down.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works, and that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
He'll get this complete to his running back, Bowden. Fighting through, and he's got space. And all the way to the opposite 45.
I don't think there's anyone who could possibly doubt how fast he could run in the open field. But if there were, he silenced those thoughts there.
Off of play action, Tagovailoa. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. Not much there, only a yard. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9.
Brings up second and 9 at the Broncos 43-yard.
Tua to throw again. He's going to look deep down the field, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Justin Simmons. How big is that penalty? Wipe out the INT.
You'd hate to be the teammate that caused that penalty and wiped out the interception. You got to face that guy in the locker room. Not a lot of fun for you, and you hurt your squad.
Tua gonna hand this one to Breida. He gets it forward for 4, maybe 5, but the flags fly, and this one could be coming back. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Complete to the running back, Matt Breida. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. And that's going to leave him with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him. We'll be back. This is Breida on the draw. And down inside the 15 he goes. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Play action, now it's Tua. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath.
And he's got his tight end, Gesicki, in the end zone. Touchdown, Dolphins. Gesicki, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins are able to draw a bit closer. Shaves a bit off the lead. It's now a 23-point game.
Broncos 37, Dolphins 14.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Broncos take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. They'll try the left side. Richmond. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily
looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jones, and they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. So they will tread backward on the holding penalty.
And I know that they're going to get coached up and they'll get yelled out a little bit, but let's face it, it is hard not to do at the speed and pace that they play.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Going for the deep ball. And this is taken in at the 5. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well. They'll get a few stops.
They'll try to run with Breida, and he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And thanks to the interception, the Dolphins offense cashes in with 6. So now the Dolphin offense will stay out there as they'll go for 2. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play. Focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Fucking minutes!
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Faking the give to Lindsey. Here's Locke. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. But they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on.
The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Thankfully for the offense, a fortuitous bounce there on the fumble goes out of bounds, because they're down here in the red zone. You don't want to lose one there.
You don't want to lose one, and the best part, because it went out of bounds, they retained possession, still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
Steps away to his left. He's going to take to a hit, and the ball is out. It's picked up by the Broncos. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Recovered by Denver.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Now a first carry for their fullback. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker. And now it's third down. From the gun, it's Locke. He's got his tight end Fant. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Locke on target to Fant for a Bronco first down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Throwing on second down, Locke. He's got his big tight end, Fant. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 23 yards the pickup there. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge. Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play. Shotgun snap, and a give to Lindsey. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. 10 more there and another first down.
Brandon, sometimes it just comes down to the power of suggestion, because I know exactly what they said all week long. We're coming off the open week. We'll have the fresher legs in the fourth quarter, and they will wilt when we get to that point. And right now, it appears that they're thinking that exact thing.
Yeah, offensively, they had the bye last week. Defensively, did not. Is that really a big factor? Is that more talk during the week?
I think the more that you talk about it, the more that you emphasize it, the more sometimes it comes true for your team.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Jones. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. So they get the takeaway, but that's just step one. They still have a lot of work to do.
But they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still a three-score game, though, fourth quarter. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Here's Tua. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Mike Gesicki, 89 yards. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead. So he's hit Pater twice, but still they're facing that deficit here in the second half.
So they're going to see if they can continue to find ways to get him the football, because obviously something is working for him to find the end zone twice. In any event, however this turns out, he's going to be hard to deal with in the film room, isn't he? He's going to want to know why he's not getting more passes thrown to him.
Those big tight ends are getting greedy. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they sit in a good spot, having the ball back after the fumble recovery and up two scores in the fourth quarter. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. This is caught at the 20. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Jerry Judy, his third touchdown of the game, number 9 on the season. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that. Truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it. 25-yard line. Tua and the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll set up the throw from the gun. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32. 7 yards, the pickup there. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath. He's got a man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
First and 10 at the 30.
So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Going to the air, Tagovailoa to a hit, and the ball is out. Able to fall on it, but look where they recovered it. That's a big loss.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. And again, it's Tagovailoa. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And he's got some space here. 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just...
And oh, he coughed it up! The Broncos say they have it. They do!
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes, but it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. And they take a knee. Set to take a knee, and that should do it for this ball game.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. They did in this one.
Dolphins 27.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball, things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Denver, it's a rare victory for them as they get that record back to 3-7. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for Miami, what else is new? They fall again. That's now 10 straight losses to start the year. And they'll get a home date next week against the Kansas City Chiefs. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles David...
See my jewels, shining, white diamonds, Miley Cyrus, private pilot, look at me, stylish, masterpiece, body, dumb.
Thank you.